We're the Anomar boys. I'm Josh. This is my brother Joe. And we're here today to give you a sneak peek of the Stry Street Rod showroom project that we completed in 2015. And then we're going to give you a little glimpse of the home renovation project that we actually just completed yesterday. That is a total surprise to the client, Brian Stry. He asked us to tile the floor and we gutted his house and gave him a major surprise. Houses here in the beautiful Okanagan for 13 years, since 07. Behind us is Stry Street Rod's showroom that we completed about 5 years ago.
Yeah, we were here for 2 years, almost 3 years, building this place, and we're still here moving stuff, helping them out, taking care of it to this day. It's a never-ending job, and it's a job of a lifetime, really. Because he's an amazing guy, and we love what we do, and we love working for him especially.
It's a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity. We've built many houses throughout the Okanagan. Houses are houses. We do them day in, and we do them day out, one after another. But this is a very unique, special project that we worked on for a showroom for some of the coolest cars around, for one of the coolest people around. And I've known Brian, well, we met probably 2 years before we started building this place. We fought with the city for a year to be allowed to build this place. We started off with creating the land for this building, because none of the land was there. So we built a 30-foot tall, 100-foot long retaining wall. And then we started designing the building. And Brian asked me for a shop for four of his favorite cars, and so once the wall was built, I flew to Edmonton to go see what we were doing, and we decided, no, we can't build you a four-car garage. We got to build you something special, and so he gave me pretty well free rein to do what I wanted, and this is the building we came up with. And along the way, he gave us some insight as to basement level being vintage, main level being a BA gas theme, and the upper level being Mexican. Mm-hmm. And this is what we came up with.
Mm-hmm. In the basement level, we went with kind of just a basic sort of open industrial theme. That's why we got the stucco on the walls and the open beams, and it's real neutral colors. And we just kind of figured that he'd hang the signs and do the stuff himself, right, at his own art, which he has. Well, we hung all the signs,
we didn't know that there was going to be years and years of decorating and hanging signs and moving gas pumps, and then you show up one day and he wants the gas pumps from the basement back upstairs, and the upstairs back downstairs.
Yeah, yeah.
So it's a bit of a never-ending project, but it's been a fun journey. I've had a lot of fun, a lot of good times, good memories along the way.
It's nice with the garage doors, you can open them all up. You're looking out at the lake.
Rather than having windows to the lake, we decided we'd put overhead doors. So when you're entertaining and you can be in and out to the patios anywhere you want through the building. You don't have to go out the door. You can go out anywhere in the building you want because all the doors are overheads. So on the main floor, we went with a BA gas theme. So that's where the colors, the green and red and white, come in. Yeah, we decided to add a shell corner into it, so that's when the yellow came into the floor.
There stood a log cabin made of earth and wood, where lived a country boy named Johnny B. Good, who never ever learned to read or write so well, but he could play a guitar just like a ring in a bell. Go, go!
Coca-Cola corner, and so that's with the red mixed with the yellow.
Go sit beneath the tree by the railroad track, old engineer machine sitting in the shade, strumming with the rhythm that the drivers made. The people passing by, they would stop and say, oh my, but that little...
We ended up having one of our airbrush buddies paint a mural on the wall of all of, not all of, but some of the cars of the collection of Sky Street Dogs, with an actual view of the lake. And the actual circumference radius of that ceiling and the bar all carried right up through into the Mexican level, right up into a sphere in the ceiling, with a wine barrel coming out of the ceiling, with all of the products upstairs actually imported from Mexico to catch that authentic Mexican look.
Mm-hmm. Very authentic and natural. Plaster, wood, clay tile. We did our own built-in furniture with nice curvature and hanging from the ceiling, there's drops. It's really unique.
Brian asked for round. So we spent probably a month and a half framing round arches, ovals, spheres. Around kitchen, it just went on and on and on, and hopefully we never built round again.
All the countertops on the main level and upstairs too, we made ourselves out of concrete. Took time, but they turned out really nice and people really appreciate them.
One of the coolest things that we built in this project was right behind us, this catwalk that attached the two buildings together. This house, the future that you'll see later on through this episode, the renovation of the existing house, we were only allowed to put a 750 square foot building. And so we attached it with this catwalk behind us. And by attaching it, we were able to go 6,500 square feet instead. And it was one of the coolest features of the build. All handmade trusses, so many different radiuses and angles. And then to cover it all with fir and have grapevines growing all over everything just really turned out amazing. One of the coolest parts of the building for sure. We'll be right back. So we decided to put the security wall in with a gate just for protection for the property. Brian had brought us this gate. It's actually out of a castle in Europe from the 18th century that we wanted to incorporate into it. I actually went into my van and I drew a little sketch on the calendar of what I thought this security wall should look like. And so we rolled with it, and this is what we came up with. And I think we nailed it pretty good with, like you say, with the gate from a castle and the bell above it. It just kind of all suited and flowed with the project.
Makes for a very grand entrance when you come in here.